This is Rob Flynn from Machine Head, and you're listening to Talk To Me.
What is up, everybody? Welcome into Talk To Me. This is episode 215. The guest this week is Steve from Skin Lab, always friend of the show, and always a great guest to have on the podcast. Steve's on to talk about the new album. There's a ton of breaking news on this episode. If you're a Skin Lab fan, you will get the album title, tour updates, drummer updates, and so much more. So I can't wait for you guys to check this one out. So we'll fly through this intro, get right to the meat of the episode, and then I will talk to you after the interview. But hopefully you guys are checking out Talk To Me live on uncontrolledknowise.com. Thursday nights, the day this posts, Thursday night, head over to uncontrolledknowise.com, and that is noise with a Z. Thursday, 8 p.m. Eastern, for 2 hours of music and interviews and so much more. Got a great lineup of guests coming up soon. And if you guys have been checking out all of the extra bonus episodes you've been getting on your Talk To Me feed, you're getting so much good stuff. Baco from Cobras and Fire, John from Brutally Speaking, Chris Sinzak from Decibel Geek, runs the gamut. It's been a lot of fun to do, man. I've been really enjoyed. I was really nervous to do the live show, but it's coming out really, really good. Chris Aiken, Classic Metal Show, John Drake, former co-host, so much stuff. So make sure you are subscribed to Talk To Me so that you get your daily dose of Talk To Me if there's stuff to post daily. One extra episode this week, should be like 4 or 5 episodes next week with the guest list I have for the live show. So it's going to be a lot of fun and making a lot of noise over there on the live show. Bobby Gustafson from Satan's Taint, making some blabbermouth news on the live show. Always fun. So yeah, make sure Uncontrolled Noise, Thursday nights, 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern. Some of the best metal news, talk, and music on the internet.
My name is Scott Bowling. I have a show called Good Company. Good Company is a show where we film artists in the rock genre, and we talk about their first record all the way to where they are now. We've interviewed bands like Korn and Seven Dust and Rich Ward. You can find me on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook under Good Company or Good Company with Bowling. So please, if you get a chance, check it out.
Good Company!
Also, guys, don't forget that the Rockin' Pod Expo, August 10th, Nashville, Tennessee. Come out, hang out with us, hang out with all of your favorite podcasts, hang out with myself, Decibel Geek, Cobras and Fire, so much more. Come hang out, have a beer with us. It's going to be a lot of fun. Get to see us do the interviews live. Going to do some live interviews with Dave Ellefson. Tom Hazard's going to be there. It's going to be a blast. It always is a blast, and it's always so much fun. And I hope you guys understand that the Rockin' Pod Expo is so laid back, and the artists are just wandering around, you know, very approachable. I think only one artist is going to charge for autographs, maybe two. So if you want to come meet your heroes and some of your favorite podcasts, make sure you're hitting up the Nashville Rockin' Pod Expo, August 10th, Nashville, Tennessee. And I will be there, so hopefully you will be too. So with that being said, let's check out some Skin Lab. Let's talk to Steve. Let's check out some more Skin Lab, and then I will talk to you momentarily.
Yeah, my second skin. Now What's up, brother?
Not much, man. Always good time to talk to you.
Fucking hey, man. It's been a year?
I guess it's almost been two, because that was the first Rockin' Pod, and Rockin' Pod 3 is coming up next month, so I guess it's been 2 years since I've seen you.
Oh, those are turning out to be pretty cool for you, huh?
Yeah, everything's been...
turning out to be pretty cool, the fun.
Yeah, everything's been a lot of fun, man, and you know, this year Dave Ellefson's going to be there, so you can't say no to that.
Awesome, man. He's pimping his ass out, isn't he?
Yeah, well, yeah, Tom will be there too. But yeah, and now Tom is singing for him, so yeah, it's all kinds of good stuff.
I think Tom's Dave's manager, from what Tom told me.
Yeah, Tom's Dave's like everything right now.
That's funny.
Well, man, it is always good to talk to you. Like I said before, Skin Lab, always one of my favorite bands, and you're one of my favorite people. So let's talk. And there's a lot to talk about. You've got so much stuff going on in the band. And let's just start with the new album. Are you done with it? It looks like you've finished up vocals. So how's that going?
Yeah, vocals are complete. We have what we call, we're doing like the chingaderos, you know, the Skin Lab, you know, all the noises and shit. the jingles and stuff. So we're done. We're over at Snake's house right now, just doing like the little tidbits. And we're actually, you know, like two songs away from being done. And, Ulrich is mixing, you know, all along while we're doing this simultaneously. So, it's coming out pretty cool. It's amazing. Cool is a way understatement, but, yeah, man, we're inches away from the finish line. You know, working with Ulrich has been amazing. You know, working with a producer again has been really cool, man. He's taken, you know, the music that we wrote to a whole another level and opened up a few doors for us. And, you know, he and Snake working together. Snake recorded the guitars with him back and forth and everything. So it's been an amazing run so far. I mean, it's pretty much been the longest time we've worked on a record, but we've never really, aside from Andy Sneap, we've never really worked with a big producer, you know? So this is, it's very cool. And, yeah, we owe our next born, whoever has the next kid, we owe that to Ulrich. You know, of course we could have never afforded it. It's been amazing. So.
Yeah. Ulrich's, his resume alone is awesome, and to see you guys being able to work with him for the new album it's going to be amazing. I know you guys do a lot of like home recording, so I mean, what's the difference for you, you know, working with someone rather than, you know, actually just recording at home?
Right. Well, we've learned to work at home, everybody. You know, we've learned how to adapt with our home studios and everything over the years, but you know, that's just kind of almost like a vicious circle when you're working by yourself. You know, seems like kind of chase your tail a lot. A lot of great stuff that comes out of it. You know, Snake, for instance, you know, he does a lot of our production at his studio, and we all have our individual home studios as well, a little dog. You know, I mean, it's great having full control over your stuff, mm-hmm. but it's also, you know, I mean, we did that the last record, and you could kind of hear it. You know, it's like we never really branched out for help, assistance, you know. It wasn't really putting our ego aside, but just having the money to go ahead and do that, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
So it's been really cool, amazing, you know, process with Ulrich. Obviously, he's recorded some of our favorite records, you know, ever, and to pick his brain on how he did that and, you know, bring those elements to Skin Lab has just been amazing. And, yeah, I mean, we sit there and we're recording at his house. I mean, you're looking at, you know, Body Count Records, you're looking at fucking Pantera, you're looking at, you know, Around the Fur, Taking a Piss, looking at, you know, Around the Fur is pretty inspiring, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
So, the Platinum Records, I'd say, you know, all the records he's got around his studio, so.
And with,
it's definitely inspiring and intimidating.
And with the Dead Tomorrow song you put out with the video about 6 months ago, was that just kind of dipping you guys' toe in the water to kind of see the reaction to Skin Lab fans if they're, you know, if they're still there, or was that just was that something you guys wanted to do?
Well, you know, this is the first time we've said this, and I guess it's about time things come out. That was the last song we recorded with Paul, and we felt that it was a good way to kind of just sever the ties and go separate ways at that point. It was a good way to send, you know, a proper, respectful goodbye to Paul with his last recording and release it to the world. We just didn't feel, we knew that he wasn't going to be on the record, so we felt that it was it shouldn't be included on the album. And that's the only reason it wasn't. We went in the studio to record the record as soon as we signed with AIW, and it just became evident that, you know, we weren't fully prepared. So that kind of caused a ripple and everything. And that's kind of where we parted ways with Paul. He decided that he wanted to bow out. And it was kind of just pretty much well past pre-production, right when we were about to get started. And that's when we were working with Juan Ortega, our buddy and local producer here. And that we kind of put the brakes on that and kind of looked at the big picture. And then Ulrich became available. And it was, you know, an obvious choice, you know what I mean? And with our new drummer, it was all, you know, the proper next step. So.
And one of the reasons I brought up, you know, did you want to dip your toe back in to see if the fans were still there? The one thing that, you know, looking at the, you know, YouTube comments and things like that, it all seemed to be very positive and very, you know, Skin Lab is back and the groove is back. And everyone was talking about that groove being back. And it seemed like everybody is pumped for this new album. So if you put it out there, you know, the way I thought, as kind of a dip in your toe in the water, I think it worked that way.
Well, we felt like the fans needed something. It's been almost, you know, 10 years at that point. And we felt like we cheated the fans out of a good couple records, you know, in that time that we had to take off. And then we just needed something out there. We had, you know, my boy Sean Glass had just begun managing us, and he's been working on developing, getting us back in, you know, on radar in the last few years. And that was just part of the development phase. And it was, you know, we needed to get it out there. And again, you know, parting ways with Paul, we felt that it was the best thing we could do was to give it out, put it out there for the fans. And, yeah, you know, I haven't read any of the comments, and I'm not one to shy away from. I take every comment, you know, as it is.
Yeah, I mean, they were definitely.
Maybe I should go check them out. But that's cool.
You know, there was a mix in there of a few people not being too happy, but yeah,
those
but majority.
Plus the Skin Lab, dude.
Majority were happy.
All good.
Well, it looks like you're going back to Australia at the end of this month, and if my math was right, and I was trying to find, did you guys do Australia about 20 years ago?
20 years? God, you make me sound so old. No, we've done Australia a couple times.
Okay.
And it was about, we'll just say 15 to make us seem a little younger. Okay, come on, Jimmy.
Well, I mean, you and I toured together 17 years ago, so...
It was 17. We have the boss here, my wife, and she said it was 17. So right. She knows when we...
Well, that's like 20. So.
Yeah, but, you know, I'm going to go ahead and announce this right now because there's been so much speculation on what's going on. The tour's been postponed. We're totally blown away. We haven't announced it yet. We're waiting on the promoter to do it. Obviously, this interview is going to come after it is announced. We're really bummed out. But the record, you know, we need to focus on the release of the record, and we were trying to hurry up and get things available for Australia, and it just didn't pan out. It looks like it was going to be best to postpone the tour. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and let you know that's what we are doing, unfortunately. It sucks because we love our Australian fans and our fan base, and I mean, they just fucking rule, but they're going to get the best Skin Lab out of this, and we'll be back. We'll be there very soon.
So is Pissing Razor still going to go, or the tour is just completely off?
The tour is postponed.
Okay.
As of now, I can't speak for the promoter. That's his responsibility.
Right.
But, yeah, we'll be back soon.
All right. Well, then we'll move on to, I'm assuming, the West Coast tour at the middle of the month is still on. It's on. Okay, there we go. So that starts August 18th through August 31st. And that looks like it's going to be a lot of fun, too. And, you know, you definitely need to branch out and get to at least the Midwest and East Coast for me. So
we do. And we're, you know, the record's going to speak volumes. You know, our manager and our label and our agent, their jobs are going to get so much more easier with the new Skin Lab record. Right now, we're going off of complete faith, memory, and diehard fans and promoters that fucking love our band. You know, and that's why we're able to get out to these places. But with a new record, everyone's job is going to be easier. It's going to be fun. I mean, I can't even begin to tell you. I mean, the record's slamming, bro. It's a monster. And I'm not going to sit here and say, you know, it seems to be the thing to say. It's not as good as our last one. It's better than our other ones, man. This is Skin Lab all the way around. If you can't tell, we're fucking ecstatic. We're so fucking excited. The production we got out of this is just amazing. I mean, again, working with Ol' Rick, I mean, we didn't get the typewriter, kick drum, kind of behemoth fucking production. We got a really fucking huge production that is full on Skin Lab, and we just can't wait to fucking let everyone hear it.
Is there a projected release date on the new album, album title, anything like that popping around?
Yeah, we're going to give you the album title first, Toomey. We've been putting out, you know, I remember you wanted some news, some breaking news a while ago. I couldn't give it to you, but now we have some. Yeah, the record's called Venomous. 10 songs of fucking brutes, man. Fucking hooks all over the fucking place, man. And the shit's huge. It's the day we debuting our new drummer, Fabian, who fucking just stepped in and laid it down, man. Serious. We're really excited to let everyone hear it with the new drummer and the fire still burns, man.
You know, the Skin Lab sound has just always been there with that, like, super groove. And, you know, like, even going back to what I was talking about earlier with the comments on the last video, you know, everyone just talking about that groove. So you're letting me know, and you're letting everybody know first off that Skin Lab groove is all over this new album, right?
All over the place. The first single is called The Overcoming. Fucking groove straight down the pipe. Straight down the pipe, dude.
Can't wait. Let's talk a little bit about San Francisco for a little bit of the Bay Area scene. You know, Slayer released their, their final tour dates today. And I know they weren't a San Francisco band, but they kind of blended in with that San Francisco sound. So, I mean, what are your memories of Slayer growing up in San Francisco?
Oh, God. I mean, as a kid, I mean, when Slayer, I mean, I was a little bit young for the whole scene, so I kind of came up after kind of they were already big, so kind of around High in the Chapel and stuff like that is what I got into Slayer. But I mean, yeah, that was a stable band. I mean, I think my first Fistful of Records were, you know, besides the Plasmatics and my Grease record and my Sugar Hill Gang record. You know, I bought, you know, what, Possessed, Seven Churches, Welcome to Hell, Death Angel, Ultraviolence, Slayer, Haunting the Chapel, and then, Live Undead, right?
Yes, yep.
And I remember just fucking playing Live Undead just, like, religiously. And it was kind of weird because my parents never had a problem with my metal. And, you know, they'd always be barging in the room while I'd be headbanging in the mirror thinking I'm Tall Bailoff, you know, fucking bonded by blood.
Nice.
And, you know, probably thought I was jerking off, but I was like, you know, fucking headbanging in the mirror. My dad's like, what the hell are you doing? I'm like, nothing. Leave me alone. You know, but it was between Bonded by Blood and Live Undead. And ironically, those two album covers, I was just telling my wife the other day, they came up missing and I never found them. But I remember on the back of Bonded by Blood, Tom Hunting's eyes were fucking glowing red, either red or green, I'm not sure. But I remember my mom looking at that picture and just like, who is that guy? He's possessed by the devil. And then, you know, I'm like, probably, you know, can you think I can go see him next weekend? Yeah.
So good, man. So I would have loved to have been around
in
that
Slayer, era. Slayer, you know, Slayer was the foundation of everything metal for me, I'd say. And of course, Metallica, you know, but, yeah, man, I mean, Slayer, Skin Lab, we got to tour with Slayer, so I can't cry one bit. We did 12 shows with them and it was fucking
nice. And getting, and Slayer taking out Phil Anselmo doing an entire Pantera set. And fans of this show know how my love of Pantera, so I will 100% be at these shows. And Phil's opening the entire thing with Ministry and Primus, and so I'm totally looking forward to this. And it's funny, I'm seeing a lot of negativity about Primus being on the bill, but what a lot of people forget is, like, Ozfest 99, Slayer and Primus played back-to-back, and it was awesome. Like, it 100% made sense. And I think as long as Primus plays some of their heavier stuff, it's going to be a pretty amazing show.
Yeah, it's going to pull off. I mean, everyone's just going for a party, man. And once you get there, you kind of forget about all the fucking bullshit, you know?
Right.
That's going to be awesome, though. Primus, and what are they opening?
Phil Anselmo, then Ministry, Primus, and then Slayer, so.
That's fucking sick, man. I could only hope I could get tickets. We'll see.
Right. Hey, I'm sure those West Coast dates are going to be even harder,
We got Caesar for Pissing Razors in fucking Ministry now. How cool is that?
That's crazy. And then, you know, Sin from Society One, take it all the way back to our tour together. He's in Ministry also, so there you go.
Well, see, that's the golden, you know, we used to always say, you want to be big, go open for Skin Lab. See, there you go.
Yeah, it's a crazy time. I don't know if we talked about this in the last time or not, and I did kind of want to bring up Glennie, you know, with his passing. I don't even know how long ago that was now, but man, one of the greatest laughs on tour that I've ever heard in my life, and what a good dude.
Yeah, the digital laugh, man. Glennie would definitely be missed. For those of you who like missed it, I think there was a live kind of thing of his memorial service, kind of little party we threw for him.
So okay.
Do that online. But, yeah, man, that sucks. Glennie was a good kid, you know. He had a heart of gold. That's obviously a contagious laugh that we ended up calling the digital laugh. I think Line 6 needs to make a digital Glennie effect.
You
know, but the laugh is, you know, it still stays with us. We all have it here and there, and you know, I was hoping to bring because we his sisters made some necklaces with a little bit of Glennie's ashes in it, and we're hoping to bring a couple to kind of, you know, as you may know, he was born in New Zealand, and we were hoping to get out there.
Oh, wow.
So we were going to bring a locket, maybe, you know, place the ocean for him. But we're going to have to do that next time.
Wow, that's heavy. The last thing, I guess, with the San Francisco stuff, you know, with Violence kind of coming back around, doing some shows. I know it looks like you toured with them, like, way, way back in, like, the early 90s, right? Like, in, it looks like Defiance,
yeah,
maybe?
Yeah. Totally. Like, Rob Flynn and Phil, they've got their freaking fingerprints all over my career. I mean, Phil, I remember the phone call with Phil asking, you know, if Defiance wanted to go on tour with Violence and Flotsam and Jetsam, and fucking shit my pants just like the day Rob called and asked me to go on tour with Machine Head. So, yeah, man, between those two dudes, you know, nothing but gratefulness. You know, and obviously they're doing just fine apart, you know, lots of squabbling and all that shit you see on in the net and all that crap, but everyone just needs to mind their own business and fucking let everyone do their thing.
Well, how am I going to get downloads if I don't get Phil talking about Machine Head? Come on, man.
right. Well, he's allowed to do press now, so that's good.
And he's doing a lot of it, and it's all great. They should have let him do it a long time ago,
you know,
just because he's a great ambassador of metal.
Well, he's a really good person at heart. And this is the thing. If you remember when Phil joined the band, he was the only guy out at all the shows. That motherfucker was like, you know, putting cameos everywhere,
right,
you know, when he first joined the band. And I truly believe that that was the main reason why Machine Head had such a welcoming back when he joined the band, you know. I mean, he was at everybody's show. He was supporting everyone, big or small, he was there. And I think that had a lot to do with it. And you might just miss that.
Yeah, he, you know, even with like bands like Nonpoint and things like that, he would jump up with that you wouldn't even expect. And the next thing you know, he's doing a couple of songs with them. And yeah, it's
absolutely.
He's a great guitar player, great dude, and I've enjoyed his kind of resurgence back into the media world.
Fuck yeah. Hey, but let's not count out Rob, man. I mean, we like his music because that motherfucker wrote some sick-ass music, and, I mean, don't count him out. Obviously, he's doing this Chris Cornell thing, and, you know, he's a man on fire still, too, so I have no doubt. You know, I'm sure he reads, you know, the critics and the fans and the last album. You know, not too many people liked it. I liked it.
I did too.
That's the one song that everyone hated. The song that everyone hated is probably one of my favorite songs.
Triple Beam?
No. The one song.
The Bastards?
The acoustic song.
Yeah, Bastards
or
whatever.
Yeah, I love that song.
Yeah, it was great. I loved it.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, it was like a Machine Head meets like Dropkick Murphys. I loved it.
Yeah, I sing it all day long if I'm listening to it, man, and that's what you want.
Yeah, and you know, another guest of the Talk To Me podcast. So we love Rob Flynn over here too. We love all of our Machine Head. You can't you can't take any of that away. Any era of Machine Head works for me. I love the Burning Red.
You got fuck yeah. I mean, Supercharger. It's all music, man. Everyone's got to stop listening for what they want it to be and listen to it for what it is, because it's not going to change. The shit is what it is.
You know, the one thing that's nice about Facebook is not only do I get to see, you know, your kids grow up and go off to the military and playing in bands and playing drums and all this other stuff. You know, you're also a fun follow, you know, when you go live. I really liked when you were doing the kind of going through the tour laminates and kind of telling everybody, you know, what's, you know, this tour and that tour. And it brings back a lot of memories for everybody. So keep doing that stuff, man. It's a fun watch.
Yeah, we're definitely going to keep doing that. We found a little niche that's going to be cool. And we have some other little Instagram things that we're starting to pop off. We're trying to – we used to be a band that related to our fans, you know, with the whole Revolting Room and shit like that. And, you know, we're not sure where we stand in the world of metal. All we know is we wrote a fucking sick-ass record that is no different than any Skin Lab record that we've ever written. We feel that it's the best one that we've written so far. And, you know, we'll see where we sit in the game.
Absolutely. And then the after the West Coast tour, that like we said earlier, starts August 18th through August 31st. Do you guys have any more dates lined up? Are you going to become Weekend Warriors, fly-in dates, all that stuff?
No, we're too old for Weekend Warriors. This is our last fucking shot. We got to do it.
Just do it.
My wife said I could.
She ready to kick you out?
No, this is what I do, you know? I've been playing music my whole life, and we think we wrote a badass record and what we need to support, and, you know, the kids are old enough to drive the bus now, so it's on.
Nice. Allison's there, right?
Yeah, she's right here.
Can she hear me?
Selling merch. She's folding our merchandise right now.
No, I don't do merch. That's not my deal.
Okay, that's the end of your interview.
Put it
hey,
to work.
Terry, don't forget, I still have that jingle coming for you, bro. I know you think I forgot.
No, I was wondering if it was coming, but I'm not going to bug you about it too much.
No. It's a song that didn't make the record, and we had to wait because I wanted to give you something, but I had so many riffs and so many songs to put in the album. I just wanted to make something totally different. Didn't want to give you a jingle of our fucking first single. You know?
Nice.
It's going to be all for you, and I'm going to make it especially for you.
Nice. Did you answer if you have stuff lined up after the West Coast tour? If you guys are ready to hit the road, or are you guys still waiting on stuff to come through?
We're hoping the record comes out late September, early October, and you know we're finally back with our old booking agency and our original booking agent John Finberg for all his fans out there, you know. And it's just time to submit. We just gotta hopefully people like the record. We're obviously a good hang. We're friends with everybody. You know, we're the funnest band to tour with. You know, so we'll see. We'll see if the floodgates open. You know, we definitely have to pay our dues, and we're looking forward to it.
I think those dues have been paid, and now it's time to collect. Yeah. So hopefully,
E-Town Concrete said, got a whole pocket full of receipts.
Nice. Well, good, man. Well, Steve, take care, and we will see you on the road hopefully soon, and a new album coming out soon, big tours coming out, and man, I can't wait for the entire world to fall back in love with Skin Lab.
Oh, man, thank you so much. We appreciate all the support, brother.
All right, man, I'll talk to you soon. Back of destruction. Can't throw this all away because you come in my obsession. Trials and tribulations, sacrifice, dedication, rise against the flames again, destroy all our fears, chasing the sun again, on a new path of redemption, can't hold our heads in shame as we're watching our destruction, through trials and tribulations, sacrifice, and dedication. Rise above the flames again, destroying all the fears. I should know more than I was on coming.
All right, guys, huge thank you to Steve from Skin Lab for coming on the show. Like always, one of my favorite guests, one of my favorite dudes in the entire planet. Definitely took me under his wing when we toured back in the day, and I will always do anything I can to help promote Skin Lab because, A, they were one of my favorite bands before I toured with them, and then after touring with them, always going to be one of my favorite bands, and I cannot wait for the new album. I think the world needs some more Skin Lab. The world always needs some Skin Lab. So make sure you're checking out the new album when it comes out. Venomous, I believe, is what it's called. Some breaking news here on Talk To Me. Check us out at the Nashville Rockin' Pod Expo, August 10th, Nashville, Tennessee. Rockin'PodExpo.com for all of your ticketing information. And then also, always, make sure to check out the live show, Talk To Me Live, Thursday nights, 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern. That would be 5 to 7 p.m. Pacific, so your drive time with Toomey. UncontrolledNoise.com. And so until next Thursday, for the Talk To Me podcast, I am Joshua Toomey, and I will talk to you soon.